In this video, I'm going to show you the eBay dropshipping order fulfillment process with Dropified that works both on Shopify, CommerceHQ, and WooCommerce. And if you stick around, I'll even show you where you can connect different suppliers for each variant on the same product page. Using eBay for your dropshipping suppliers, especially if you find a US supplier, allows you to avoid all that time you waste when you're trying to ship things from China using AliExpress. Finding US suppliers is better for you, it's better for your customers, they get them faster, and you can even use larger products. So here we are inside of Dropified. I already have this product I want to add. I just click the Add Supplier button, and this is the information I need. So let's jump over to eBay. And I found two products here. Found this one that's 5232. The suppliers over here, they charge 99 cents for shipping, and they're in California, right? Roland Heights. So I've got this, found this second product. So I found two suppliers. This one's a little bit more, a different supplier, but it's free shipping, and it's from the same place. So actually, without the shipping, this one is going to cost less. So this one has multiple variants. But there's only one that I have that I need that's on the store. So I'm going to copy the link. I'm going to bring it back over here to Dropified, paste in the link, and then I'm going to add the supplier name. So I'm going to jump back over to eBay, and I'm just going to copy this supplier name. Copy that. And then bring it back over to Dropified, and I'll put it in here. And I like to put in, you know, where the supplier is, like if they're on a platform like AliExpress or eBay. So I'm going to put eBay in here. And this is just, the customers don't see this. This is just for me and my virtual assistants. I usually don't put anything for the supplier store link, but I do put in here the price. Because one thing about eBay is the price can fluctuate regularly. So you do want to check that when you're processing orders. And I'll tell you more about that in just a minute. So I put it in here, you know, the price that I find it at that moment. And then if there's a big difference, I'll go find another supplier. So there we've actually connected the product, and now you can see the place order button shows up. So I can now place an order. So when you do place an order, you have three options: auto fulfillment, you know, you can auto choose a shipping, and you can do step-by-step order. So in this case, I'm gonna do the step-by-step order because I haven't set up the variants yet, but I will do that. So right now, you can see here's the pricing. I just need to click on color and choose the variant for the product that my customer purchased, which is this one. And for some reason it said two. Maybe the customer purchased two. Yep, sure did. So this customer purchased two of these products. So you can see Dropified had already selected the two on the product page. So it already knows. It's collecting all the information from your order and taking it over to eBay. And now let's continue. So I'm going to switch this back to buy two. That way, because my customer ordered two. And then I'm going to click up here where it says confirm order. I could click on the add to cart or buy it now button. But I like to click on the button. I'm going to choose no thank you for the information. Here I am on the checkout page. You can see that the customer's information was added. And now I just need to update my, enter my credit card information. So I have it automated, it's saved. So I'm going to enter that in now and confirm. And the next thing it will do is, you can see down below, there it is. There's the customer's name. It's already been updated. And yeah, Cheryl Evans. So I'm just going to double check it, make sure that all that is the same. And then I'm going to scroll down. You can see that I have it set up. It enters a message automatically to the supplier because I don't want them putting the pricing in there. You know, the customer paid over $75 for each of these. I don't want them to see that it's coming. So here's it's going to arrive on December 15th, UPS SurePost shipping. And I got a discount because I purchased two. So today is the 8th. So it's going to arrive in a week. So I'm just going to continue by clicking the place order button and then wait for it to process. eBay is kind of slow. So if you're using a virtual assistant or you're doing it, you want to wait until, you know, it's done. You kind of want to pay attention. And the order's placed. So I'm just going to double check there. It says that it's the customer's information. You can see that now it shows here order placed, and Dropified actually enters a note in your order. So you can always come back later to see. You can click on that link and go directly to that order on eBay. you know, to check the status if it gets delayed. But I haven't any problem. So now let's add those variants on the mapping. So here on the variant mapping page, you can see I only have the one variant imported. And I'll just show you here. You've got advanced mapping right up here. But I'm going to click on this variant and I'm going to map it to that specific product. So next time I can just click the auto order and it'll be done. Everything will be done by itself. Isn't that the coolest thing? So you can get your own copy of Dropified at dropsolo.com/Dropified. And you can install this, like I said, on CommerceHQ, WooCommerce, and Shopify. And you even have this cool feature for bundle mapping. So if you want to combine products on your store, you can actually process those automatically. So if you like this, be sure and subscribe to my video. This is William with the Dropshipping Report. If you have any other questions on Dropified, drop me a message down in the comments, and I'll see you in the next video.